Hi everyone, this is Soumya from Ashu's Pilates, and today's workout is all about Pilates and balance. If you want to learn a little bit about how balance works in the body, please go check out our blog on ashuspilates.com titled Pilates and Balance. Just a disclaimer, if you have any condition like vertigo, dizziness or anything else that causes imbalance, please do consult with your doctor and get a consult with one of our in-house physios before you attempt this workout. And if not, if you just want to work on improving and maintaining your balance, follow along and enjoy it. Today we're working with a skater who does a lot of one-legged work, so he definitely needs to keep his balance and unilateral strength for his tricks. Unilateral means one-sided work, so we're going to work a lot of one-arm work and one-leg work just to balance muscles out on both sides of the body. Follow along, enjoy the workout, and as always, like and subscribe to Ashu's Pilates on YouTube and Instagram. Thank you. Now we're going to work a little bit with the Pilates soft ball to do some deep neck flexor activation and to understand how to align the head and neck in a neutral position so that it doesn't throw you off balance when you're doing certain movements. So we're going to place the ball behind the back of the head, leaving the neck free. Now you're very gently going to press into the ball, straight into the ball, and release the tip. Keeping that tomato, keeping the ears in line with the shoulders. Now don't move everything, just head and neck. Just press back and release. Good. Maybe 4 to 5 more reps right here. Okay, keep it going. Keeping the weight in the center of both feet. And then from here, you're going to keep that gentle press into the ball and give me a small nod. So I want you to think of rolling the ball upwards, stretching the back of the neck and activating the deep neck flexor muscles. Okay, do about 3 to 4 more right here. Watching that the rest of the body doesn't go. So a little bit less on the body. Alright, 2 more. Keep it going. Last one. And then again keeping the ball aligned, lightly pressing to the ball. And I want you to look from one side to the center to the other side. Straight, fix your eyes on any one spot and do drop that muscle in. just try to use this to help you balance it. We call it genie arms. And you're going to press back using the quads for back. And four. Keep your belly button held in. Last three. And two. And last one. And back to center. All right, come over to the other side. Let's have you go onto your knees, right? not the easiest, but it's a little bit tougher in the sense of the body. He can make it even harder by going all the way out. So let's actually go there just to show it. And you see how much it's moving. So I actually need to place my foot here to sort of align the muscles. So please make sure you do that. And then the other option is to make it easier. So he's going to come all the way here and stick his knee against the shoulder stock. So let's have him start here. And then we're going to kind of make it tougher as we go. Holding the short strap in your right hand. This one is called draw saw. So we're going to start with the arm at belt level. And then you're going to draw that sword up as you go. Take a deep breath in. Lift the arm open through the wrist to face front. And then you're very slowly going to put your sword back into it. That looks good. We're going to keep looking straight towards where we are. We're going to do two more right here. So inhale. Lift the arm, open the wrist to face front. Open the wrist to face front. There we go. Exhale, pull it up. And let's have you do the last one right here. So we go up. Usually avoid doing any of these movements really fast because it's extremely light and you can fall. So be a little bit careful there. Now let's add a little bit of rotation to this. So I want you to twist the chest to face that side. Twist the chest to face that side. Only the chest, not the hips. And then as you draw that sword, you're going to twist the chest to face away from you. Along with your arm. Twist, twist, twist away. Good. And then again, put it back, twisting towards the towel. Take a deep breath in, and now you're going to twist along with your arm. And last one. Sword back, chest goes to the towel, and then you can twist away. And back to center, okay? Let's have you go to the other side now. So we're going to put the strap back, turn around. So let's make it a little bit harder now. Let's have you go a little bit further away. All the way up, and be careful right there. The figure needs to give you better balance. And here, very slowly, take the strap into your left hand. Okay, so first we're going to draw a sword without rotating the chest. Inhale, exhale for three. Lift from the arm, raise the palm to the front. There we go. Put it back down. Now try to not lock your elbows to do that. Let's have you just connect your wrist to your belly button. Thank you. drop, come back into center. That's how you do two more. Exhale as you go, keep the belly elevated. Inhale and back. And last one.